Hello and welcome to the Racecourse International Stadium, where we are ready for the second game of today's tournament between Japan and Nepal. The first game just ended with Sri Lanka beating Bhutan 5-2. Bhutan suffering their second consecutive defeat of the tournament, while Sri Lanka did well to bounce back from their 3-1 defeat to Japan yesterday. Japan are the favourites for the tournament, and they'll be up against the Nepal under-16 team, who have played well. They are in good form. They beat Bhutan 7-1. So they'll be bringing with confidence coming into this game. Japanese team undoubtedly very strong. They have good footballing structure and a competitive J-League, which has allowed them to develop good talent, and they've become one of the leading teams in Asia as a result of the footballing infrastructure. And it's a good experience for teams like Sri Lanka, Bhutan and Nepal from the South Asian region to play against teams like Japan, just to get a feel for what top level football is. And Japan is about as good as it gets when talking about Asian football. Here we go, the teams now making their way to the center. Flag of Nepal and the flag of Japan. The Nepalese flag, one of the few flags which is not rectangular. Fun fact. As they struggle to get it in order. The boys with the Japan flag have a much easier task. And here come the two teams, Nepal versus Japan. The South Asia Japan under-16 Four Nation tournament. As we kick things off in the second game of the tournament held today. Yesterday was the first day of the tournament. As Japan in white and the Nepal team in red line themselves up. We'll now have the two national anthems of the teams. Proud occasion for many of the young lads out there representing their country at the under-16 level in a foreign country. Thank you. sorry for that minor technical issue as both teams are being introduced to today's guests of honor. The Japanese invitees, along with Mr. Anuro De Silva and Mr. Balendra Anthony. First, I have the national anthem of Nepal. And now we have the national anthem of Japan. We are done with the national anthems. Let me just walk you through the teams for today. Nepal, the starting lineup of Roshan Thapa, Roshan Dong, Shishir Leki, Rana Magar, Ranjan Poon, Randeep Paudel, Prithvi Chowdhury, Padam Batrai, Carlos Bakaria, Deepak Bandara, and Birjesh Chowdhury. And the Japanese team, Yamada Taiki, Saku Maya, Furuzono Takumi, Suzuki Kaito, Shimokawa Tayo, Watanabe Rohei, Nishikawa Jun, Kondo Kraba, Yoshida Yuji, Sumi Koshiro, and Wedo Keita. So again, as the teams huddle up for their team photos, Japan playing in white and Nepal in red. You can see some of the Japanese players towering over even the match officials for today. They do have a big height advantage despite their tender age. And they're nice to see both teams mixing up for photo of the big occasion. Nepal and Japan both looking to try and pick up their second win of the tournament. And it looks like we are done with photographs. And skippers of both teams now will toss to decide who attacks which side. Prithvi Chaudhary, skipper of the Nepal team. And of the Japanese team, it's Nishikawa Jun. Referee for the day is Ashanta Dias. And we'll get things off a few seconds from now. Japan playing from left to right of screen. And Nepal, the underdogs, which this clash, playing from right to left. It was a pretty good defensive performance from Sri Lanka that limited Japan to just 3 goals yesterday. Whereas Nepal's attack was in fine flow when they beat Bhutan 7-1. Nepalese team still in their team huddle. Need to get their tactics right. Head coach of the Nepalese team is Sunil Kumar Shestra. And Nepal will kick things off for us. Second of the day and the fourth match of the South Asia Japan Under 16 trophy. Early chance as the skipper is released wide from Japan. Tries to dink across into the box, cut out by the Nepalese defense. Lovely early piece of play by Japan, that cross cut out by the defender only just about as Japanese attack keeps coming. And the deflected shot is collected by the Nepalese goalkeeper. First piece of action for him in what will undoubtedly be a busy night for him. It's Roshan Thapa. And his kick isn't the greatest as well as Nepal can't seem to get the ball out of their half as slight mistake by the centre back. Here's the skipper. Lovely back heel. And Nepal living dangerously. Long ball into the box, but no one there. The keeper, Thapa, has no problems whatsoever. Picking up the ball as this clearance is far better in terms of distance, but direction again an issue. As the ball goes out of play.
particular pass
not remaining in play. Nepal with a throw. The Nepalese skipper will have his work cut out in midfield. And they have a free kick. So that infringement. Chance to get the ball forward for Nepal. Good take from the goalkeeper. Japan, poor pass on that occasion as they try to bring the ball forward from the back. Lifted ball across the field. Skipper gets to it. He's been in the thick of things. Japanese skipper, and he loses his footing on that particular occasion after beating his man. Goal kick for Nepal. Taking his time. Nepalese goalkeeper. And the smallest player in terms of size on the pitch, Japanese number 6, that's Tayo. Good tackle one there by the left wing, but he can't keep the ball in play. Throwing for Japan. All these young Japanese players very good on the ball. See some silky skills as comes a right back. It's a good looking cross cleared away at the first post. And the skipper just can't find his man. And wins a throw in instead. And another throw for Nepal. Defensive work there by Batrai. He's being called into action several times in these first 5 minutes. Here's Jun with a bit of space, cuts inside, goes along the ground, and a good save by Roshan Thapa in the Nepalese goal. It was only going to be a matter of time before Japanese skipper decided to chance his luck, cutting inside and unleashing a low drive with his left foot. But the goalkeeper up to the challenge on this occasion, makes a good save to keep the score at nil all. Japan have looked very threatening, particularly down this right hand side, and another good take by the goalkeeper. Couldn't afford to spill that one. It's Takumi on the overlap. Japanese right back. Yes, Nepal just can't keep hold of the ball in the opposition half. from Japan once again. Good movement from their players, this time down the left. Cuts it inside. So Napal just about winning the ball back. Here's the skipper now on the ball, trying to drive his team forward. This pass intercepted. But Japan have given it away. You can see that whenever Napal are on the ball, their opponents pressing and hustling them to try and get them off. Now the throw in for Japan in advanced position. On the outside, crossed inside, and a good defensive header. Two players are down. After that collision, the Japanese player is up on his feet already. He looks okay. It's Butterai once again in the thick of things in the Napal box. He's picked up a bit of a knock. He looks okay to continue. Referee Ashan Dias has awarded Napal a free kick, as well as it doesn't look good for Butterai, who was just staggering a bit there. Head injury is always a cause for concern. And the referee wants him taken off the field to receive treatment. Let's hope it's not a concussion or anything serious. Dias wants that free kick taken again. It's taken short. And Japan now on the ball. Here's the skipper, Jun. Taken out of the game by three Napalese defenders, as Japan once again not allowing any time on the ball for Napal. Here they come. But 1-2 goes astray. Right back Takumi unable to get on the end of that pass. Japan have allowed for 5 under 19 players to be included in the squads of their opponents in this tournament based on the strength of their players. Only four, those under 19 players will play only against the Japanese team. They've given the teams a chance to be competitive. And so far, Napal, though they haven't really threatened the Japanese goal, they've defended well. And yet another Japanese attack comes to nothing. Takumi plays it to Jun, and a good tackle there put the ball out of play. Japan on the ball once again. Long ball into the box, just evades the run of Yuji. And the hero for Nepal so far is an easy take. Clear foul there by the Nepalese keeper. Just pulling the jersey off the player, and the referee wants that free kick taken again. Lovely skill shown by the right back, and he's hauled to the ground by the Nepalese defender, who was completely fooled by that piece of footwork. Chance for Japan from this set piece to try and threaten the Nepalese goal. Defender taking one for the team on that occasion, as there was space to run in behind him. It's going to be Keita with the delivery. It's a good ball to the front post, and somehow it's found its way over the bar as Nepal survive. As the skipper Jun plays his way out of trouble. Chip ball over the top, chance for the forward, but the referee has pulled it back for a foul on the player, who was lucky to get away without a booking. Let's hope he hasn't forgotten his cards. It was clean through on goal, and he certainly was favourite to get to that one ahead of the Nepalese defender. An interesting free kick tactic used by Japan. Mind you, if they score, the rules regarding offside are, if there's a player who is infringing in play in front of the goalkeeper, he will be considered offside. As the defender now makes his way away from the goalkeeper. It's a good free kick, but it's taken a deflection and gone wide. If the defender was standing in front of the goalkeeper and the shot was fired goalwards, as long as the goalkeeper doesn't do anything, probably would be called offside. As a Japanese corner now. Into the far post, a towering header, and that's the opening goal. Sako Maya, defender powering a header past the Nepalese defender. He's one of those tall lads we were talking about at the start. He rose pretty high to put that header past the goalkeeper. No way anyone was getting close to him. And Japan take the lead. A well-deserved lead, it must be said, as they have dominated things right from the word go. Attempt from range. No problems for the Japanese goalkeeper. He's had very little work to do. Yamada Taiki in the Japanese goal. So here come Japan once again. Can that goal serve to be the spark to open the floodgates? These players not quite on the same wavelength. It's that little back heel goes to waste as the skipper Jun closed down quickly. Japanese throw. Cleared it away. And the goal scorer now just mopping up at the back. The Nepal have a chance to get the ball forward from this throw, flicked on. Just that they're not winning many of the headers against the taller Japanese players. Nice piece of skill there by the Nepalese player to keep hold of the ball as the Nepal putting in a few good passes. It's a good place of play by Nepal, but the Japanese right back finally puts in a tackle to end hopes of a goal as here they come once again. Cutback is deflected. And Nepal now look to try and work their way forward on the counter, but the pass is too long and the goalkeeper has come a long way out from his box to cut out that attack and set Japan on their way again. Good work by the right back to keep the ball in play. Great head down chance, and the second goal has arrived. Good finish by Kondo Kraba. A great team goal there. Good work by Takumi and then the skipper Jun to get the ball into the box. The head down was right on the spot. And Kraba making no mistake with the finish. Great play by Japan as they come again. Only just cut out. Question doesn't seem to be is whether they will score again. It's more about how many they will score. They look to be particularly dominant today. Effort from range by the right back goes over the bar this time. come Japan once again. Worked out to the right pack, who's been running tirelessly, and last ditch challenge there. Denying Kraba another attempt at goal. Looks like the player will need some treatment after that defensive effort. Players using that injury, it's the time to get some words of advice from the manager. Have a sip of water. So very humid conditions. And though it's cool at night. Player is up on his feet, and Nepalese team are all over the place. They need to get back to their positions quickly. Referee is not obliged to wait for them to get into position, as here come Japan. Great skill again from the young midfielders, but not quite on the same wavelength as their skipper. That one's gone out of play. That one's a foul called against a Japanese player. Just a bit too eager to get to the ball. It's Ryohei. Long ball played forward, cleared away. Lovely threaded pass through to the skipper. Jun cuts inside, still on the ball, but the defense crowded him out. Japan now plot their next move. Fighting hard in midfield, have Nepal. But so far, it's the silky skills of the Japanese that have prevailed in the midfield battle. Cleared away for the forward to run into, but again, just as it looked like it would drop for him, tall figure of Kaito taking the ball away from the forward, denying Nepal an opportunity to pull a goal back. A miscommunication there between the Nepal defense and the goalkeeper. Not sure the keeper needed to come out for that. And Japan winning themselves a free kick in a good position. They can get their tall center backs into the picture. Sakomayo looking to add a second. That free kick didn't quite set for the forward. It's still a chance though, and there's that man once again. The centre back dragging his shot wide on his left foot. Nepal survive. played down the wing but cut out by the Nepal defense. Once again, cleared away. Working the ball around the back, great skill there once again to just not do anything and fool the defender. It's that attempt to find the forward, runs out of play for a goal kick. Half an hour in, Japan looking more than comfortable, sitting on a 2-0 lead. Chip ball over the top, cut back, chance once again. One just over the post. But Japan just continue to keep carving out opportunities for their players. Defender managing to nutmeg himself with that pass. Bounce not doing him any favors. Luckily for him, he was under no pressure. So that particular patch seems to be treacherous. Pitch still under a lot of sand, making the bounce a bit uneven. Lovely turn there, great piece of skill. Can he put the cross in? It's way too long though. And runs out of play for a goal kick. But some of the footwork shown by these young lads up there, this will be nothing short of superb. As Nepal are making their first change. It's number 15. It's going off. Rana Magar, and he's being replaced by 17. That's Saugat Kavas. Ball still on the ball, cut out there by the right back. Chance for the skipper to open his tally for the night. Here comes the skipper, one on one, and makes no mistake, a clinical finish. And Japan, after struggling to score for the first 15 minutes, have tripled that tally in the next 15. As this time, it's the skipper who gets on the score sheet, Nishikawa Jun. Just from nothing, a quick counter-attack. He's able to keep his composure and slot past the oncoming goalkeeper. Japan somehow make their way into the box once again. Another chance and another goal. All started with a dazzling run from Shimokawa Tayo. And Krabo gets his second, and we'll take a small commercial break. For that short break, some technical issues. As Japan with another chance, and they've walked the ball into the net again. It's that man, Kondo Kraba, who's picked up his hat trick with that goal. As Japan now, the floodgates really have opened. 5-0. This looks like it could get pretty embarrassing for Nepal. In fact, I dread to think of what happens when the Japanese take on Bhutan. It's taken a while for them to find the back of the net, but comes as no surprise that they are 5-0 up. They've been dominant right from the word go. And they are well on their way to reaching double figures if they continue to play this level of efficiency. Chance for Nepal to get the ball into the opposition half, but that free kick is easily gathered. Yamada Taiki in the Japanese goal. Keeper has had very little to do. The players in front of hitting the pitch. Time cut out by the Nepalese right back. As Nepal are making their second substitution of the game, it's number 13. It's going off, Deepak Bandara, and he's been replaced by the number 4, another defender being thrown into the mix. That's Sanji Barrial. As they look to try and stem this flow of goals for the Japanese. Here's Jun, sets he's forward on his way, but he showed too much of the ball to the Nepalese defender, and a great piece of defensive work to put in a sliding tackle and get the ball out for a throw-in. Good run on the overlap. Still on the ball though. Here's Jun. Gets it back. Decides to go goalwards. Unleashes a shot. Ferocious shot. But just past the near post. Much to the relief of the goalkeeper. Great skill there by the captain. His decision making has been good. He knows when to pass and when to cut inside and have a go. Keeps him unpredictable, makes it difficult for defenders. Here he is once again. Gets past his man. He's been brought down in the box, but nothing from the referee as Japan have to settle for a corner kick. I beg your pardon, it's been given as a goal kick. So nothing comes off that particular Japanese move. Kondo Kraba trying to thread his man through, unable to do so. Japan win the ball back in midfield, but they've lost out. Come Japanese once again. It's getting a bit scrappy, some passes are going astray now. But neither team really able to keep hold of the ball. It's once again, position exchange hands. Here's June. Cross in from Kraba. Gathered easily by the goalkeeper. But this has been Nepal's problem. They've struggled to keep possession of the football. And just as it looked like they may get their first corner kick of the game, they'll have to settle for a throw-in in advanced territory. That's the goal scorer who opened the scoring today, Sako Mayo. Makes a good sliding tackle. Come Nepal with the throw. It's fighting towards the goal, but again, no real concern for the Japanese goalkeeper. He bowls it out to his defender as they get things underway again. Just 3 minutes to go for a well-earned breather for the Japanese. And Nepalese youngsters will need some time to just pick themselves up and try to improve on their defensive work in the second half. Here's June. Cuts inside. Still on the ball. Tries to find his teammates, but his pass is cut out. Offside called against a Japanese winger. In fact, the first offside decision of the game. Ball winning the battle in midfield on that occasion. It's the skipper still the skipper, but when it came, the time came to pick out a pass, just failing to find the man in front of him. So it's all becoming a bit untidy as the first booking of the game is given to the Nepalese number 4. Doesn't seem happy with that decision. He says his jersey was being tugged. And a chance for Japan to get the ball into the Nepalese box once again. Free kick taken short. Center backs just exchanging passes, trying to draw some of the players out. Through ball for the right back is short, and some good defensive work from the Nepalese defender. Gives away a free kick, throw in, I beg your pardon. Crossed in, there's a man far post, but he was his hands were up and he was pushing the defender, marking him. So a bit of respite for Nepal. It's that free kick is given their way. We'll have 1 minute of added time at the end of the 45. Been very few stoppages, to be fair. Here come Japan. Time the pass cut out again. And it looks like this throw may be the last piece of action for first half. Chip ball forward, cleared away. And that's the end of the first half. Japanese under 16 team completely dominant as they've put 5 past the Nepal youngsters. It took a while coming, the first goal, but then after that, Kondo Kraba hit himself a hat-trick to put Japan in full control of the South Asia Japan trophy. Against Nepal, firmly in the Japanese control. As do join us again in 15 minutes for the second half on thepapare.com.
Daily sports updates. Wherever you are, tune into the papare.com at 6:30 p.m. on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
Technique, tactics, attack. defend, pattern, back to the board, the rugby analysis.
Top shop for Sri Lankan rugby.
What's happening here? The time for
England.
Hey, welcome to Hope Centric Yoga. I'm your host, Hope. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to thepoparay.com. Special thanks to Body Bar for the location and iPhone Sri Lanka for the video production. Follow me on Instagram at featherpalm_fox.
The Hero Cup second ODI between Sri Lanka and Australia. Australia leading the series 1-0. The news is that Angelo Matthews has won the toss.
Mission to uplift the fitness arena in Sri Lanka.
Daily sports updates. Wherever you are, tune into the paparay.com at 6:30 PM on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
Technique, tactics, attack, defend, pattern. Back to the board, the rugby analysis.
Top shop for Sri Lankan rugby.
What's happening here? The time for
England.
Hey, welcome to Hope Centric Yoga. I'm your host, Hope. for watching. Do subscribe to thepopparade.com. Special thanks to Body Bar for the location and iFilm Sri Lanka for the video production. Follow me on Instagram at featherpalm_fox.
The Hero Cup second ODI between Sri Lanka and Australia. Australia leading the series 1-0. The news is that Angelo Matthews has won the toss.
Mission to uplift the fitness arena in Sri Lanka.
Daily sports updates. Wherever you are, tune into the paparay.com at 6:30 PM on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
Technique, tactics, attack, defense, pattern. Back to the board, the rugby analysis.
Top shop for Sri Lankan rugby.
What's happening in the time for?
Welcome to Hope Centric Yoga. I'm your host, Hope. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to thepopparade.com. Special thanks to Body Bar for the location and iFilm Sri Lanka for the video production. Follow me on Instagram at featherpalm_fox.
The Hero Cup second ODI between Sri Lanka and Australia. Australia leading the series 1-0. The news is that Angelo Matthews has won the toss.
Diaries. in a mission to uplift the fitness arena in Sri Lanka.
Daily sports updates. Wherever you are, tune into the paparay.com at 6:30 PM on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
Technique, tactics, attack, defense, pattern. Back to the board, the rugby analysis.
Top shop for Sri Lankan rugby.
What's happening here? The time for
Hi, welcome to Hope Centric Yoga. I'm your host, Hope. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to thepaparay.com. Special thanks to Body Bar for the location and iPhone Sri Lanka for the video production. Follow me on Instagram at featherpalm_fox.
The Hero Cup second ODI between Sri Lanka and Australia. Australia leading the series 1-0. The news is that Angelo Matthews has won the toss.
Hello and welcome back to the Racecourse Stadium, where the second half has just got underway. Japan, of course, dominating that first half. We have a 5-0 advantage going into the second half. They've also made one change during the break. Number 13, Yoshida Yuji, replaced by number 15, Nakano Keita. Long ball played forward, trying to pick out the skipper, but that one's going to run out of play. Nepal really needing that breather to try and collect themselves. One thing that will give them some hope is that Japan failed to score in the second half yesterday against Sri Lanka. And I'm sure if you offer this scoreline to Nepal now, they'll be more than happy to take it. Here's the skipper, Jun. Goes around the outside of his man, cuts it back in. Shot blocked. Still on the ball, lovely piece of work. He's prodded it, here's the goal. He's hit the post, and the skipper completes the job. Kondo Kraba smashing that close range shot off the crossbar. But luckily for him, it fell to the feet of his skipper, Shikawa Jun. And he made no mistake with the follow-up. Yes, within 5 minutes of the restart, Japan have found the back of the net. Ominous signs for Nepal. Nepal trying to go forward, the attack is cut out. First piece of action for the Japanese keeper. He won't need a shove after this game by the looks of it. It's been all very straightforward for him. This one is worked over the top for Krabo. Set it for his player. He's been brought down and a penalty. Really was a careless challenge there. And Japan have an opportunity to make it 7-0. As it's only getting worse for Nepal. And the player who's won the penalty has an opportunity to convert it himself. That's Sumiko Koshiro. Number 16. Up against Roshan Thapa. Can Japan make it 7 from this spot kick? And it's a good save by Roshan Thapa. Something to smile about finally for Nepal. It wasn't a particularly good penalty, it must be said. Lacked power and direction. And the keeper had to only guess the right direction, and it was all very straightforward from there. Because now they have this corner to deal with. And that one has drifted out wide, so glorious chance for the seventh goes a-begging. But mark my words, they'll have plenty more in the remaining 40 minutes. To score that 7th. Bit of confusion there between the goalkeeper and the defender. Here come Nepal on the attack. Poor pass by the skipper, gives it away to his opposite number. And Jun has released his winger, cuts inside, great skill. Picks out his man and fallen right at the feet of the man who missed that penalty, Koshiro. But he's unable to get his name on the score sheet. So that's another poor goal kick. It's a throw-in to Japan. There are two footballs on the pitch. As Japan are readying two more substitutions. First one is Watanabe Ryohei. He's coming off. To be replaced by number 14, that's Naruoko Hikaru. And number 5, that's Suzuki Keito, is replaced by Araki Ryotaro. Here comes Skipper Jun. Sends two defenders tumbling to the ground. That cross in has made its way to the far post. And there's a Nepalese player down, and that effort just evades the far post. It's Koshiro's hunt for getting on the score sheet continues, and Nepal have a defender down. Like his hand has been trod on. Passed all the way back to the goalkeeper. Come the Japanese once again. Lost his footing on that occasion. Good piece of skill by the substitute to keep the ball in play. So here come Nepal with their skipper. Chance for Nepal, and swing at it. Swing and miss there. From number 11, Ranjan Poon. Here comes the Japanese on the counter attack. Play on, says the referee. It's getting a bit combative there in the middle. The Nepalese players, understandably, a bit frustrated. Japan have a free kick here. Chance for that seventh. Score of the first goal, Sakomayo is tallest man in the box by a good 6 inches. Can he connect with the delivery? Delivery is good, and to the far post, Sakomayo heads it. Easily winning that header above everyone else. But good goalkeeping by Roshan Thapa. As kept the score at 6-0. It's not been much of a contest, to be honest. And this was a boxing match, it would have ended a long time ago. But this is football, and here's skipper Joon, one-on-one, and he's hit the side netting with that opportunity. Great turn of pace, completely fooled the defenders. Nepal launched the ball forward again. Here comes Japan once again, shout for a penalty again, and the referee has given a goal kick. Certainly was a very good shout for a penalty, but referee on this occasion giving the decision in favor of Nepal. Come the fresh legs of the substitute, running forward from defense, and the skipper is now on the ball. It's hard to believe that he's still under 16. That's a good shot and a lovely goal. It's 7-0. And Nakano Keita has his first of the night. Wonderful low left-footed drive. Nothing Roshan Thapa could do about that one. And Japan look good money to make double figures here tonight. Still over half an hour's play left. Could inflict some real humiliation on their Nepalese rivals tonight. Cleared away. It's Japan once again in possession, as they have been for most of the game. Here they come once again, this time on the left. First half, we saw most of the attacks coming down the right-hand side, as that one's a good acrobatic finish there from that cross, but off target. As Japan making another substitution, as Sako Mayo, goal scorer, is coming off to be replaced by Handa Riku. And given the ball away, Japan in defense, one of the first few mistakes as Nepal look to try and capitalize, but that attack has petered out. And the skipper can't release his winger. Nepal have a throw. Bhutan now, I beg your pardon, Nepal, making a substitution of their own with number 5 coming off to be replaced by number 6. But here's a Japanese forward, great piece of skill. The ball goes back to their goalkeeper. He launches it forward. Nepal get the ball to their wide man. That ball's played invitingly for the forward and wild swing at it, but going nowhere near the goal. They've been better off trying to play that one across the face of goal, as here come Japan again. Out to the right back. Cross in. They've dealt with the first ball. Second one is cleared as far as the midfield. It's coming back at them. Cleared again. Back heel, and the right back has made a complete fool of the defender, and it's a lovely goal. Brilliant work from the right back, that's Furuzino Takumi. He was superb in the first half, and this is the first we've seen of him in the second half, and he set it on a plate for his forward. And Japan now leading 8-0. Koshiro getting on the score sheet for the first time. We've had 5 goal scorers today with that goal, and things really do look dangerous for Nepal. That's a poor pass. Attempt from well out by Ranjan Poon. He's won his team a throw in. And Japan making another substitution. Number 9, their skipper, Nishikawa Jun, is being taken off to be replaced by Suto Naoki. Been brilliant. The Japanese skipper scored 2 and certainly played a big part in why Japan are leading so comfortably. These runs down the right is the other reason why they're ahead. Kondo Kraba. And Japan winning a throw-in in an advanced position. They will continue to look for double figures. Lovely pass. It's on a plate. And he gets bundled over. But amazingly, referee Ashan Dias decides not to award a penalty. And free kick given. Japan's way to that infringement. Number 18, Ueda Kita, has taken over the captain's armband for Japan. The corner kick has been awarded to them after that good piece of defensive play. One of the booth, the Nepalese players is down and chance to make it 9. But Nepal get the danger cleared. As great piece of pressing by the Nepalese forward on that occasion. His team are really in it. They've got a mountain to climb and they've not had much opportunities up front, but still willing to chase that down, and another good committed clearance by the Nepalese defender. They've been outplayed and outclassed by this Japanese team, but you can't fault them for a lack of effort. It's an interesting corner strategy by Japan. That one again doesn't make it past the first man, who puts in a diving header. All the Japanese players are outside the box as the corner taker absolutely fizzes it in. This one has a bit more loop on it and header missed at the first post. But they have a throw in. Come Japan once again. 20 minutes left in this game. Lovely footwork there, and it's only just cleared away, but it's going to come back at them. Right back, Takumi trying his luck and getting on the score sheet. Unable to make a clean connection and just hooks his shot over. Immediately as the defender gets the ball, defender is on him, putting pressure on him. The Japanese have done that very well today. Here's Takumi. Through ball, chance for Japan, and this time the defender gets back in time to prevent a tap-in, clearing the ball away. Nakano Keita to take this corner kick. Fizzing it in, goes past everyone. Not many of the Japanese players making a run into the box on that occasion. Cleared long, the hope of finding one of their forwards, but great running by the Japanese forward. Equally good defending by the covering defender, but that's one of the basic laws of defending. Don't watch the man. Make sure you get to the ball first and then shepherd it out of play. The Nepalese defender had only eyes for his opposite number, who was able to get to it ahead of him. And this one, a great save yet again by Roshan Thapa. As the chances keep coming for Japan. Reminder that they missed a penalty as well. And if not for this performance in goal today by Roshan Thapa, it could have been much worse. Nepal have a player on the pitch injured. Looks like it's going to be okay to continue though. And a yellow card given to the offender, that's Sutoh Naoki. One of the substitutes brought on today. Does Japan have a throw in? Is Naoki dazzling run? His cutback isn't properly cleared, but it's fallen to a Nepalese defender. It's wave after wave of Japanese attack. That one runs out of play. Possession won back by Nepal. They've cut the ball forward to Rana Magar. He's unable to make anything of it though. Cleared away but he's been dispossessed, the defender. Luckily for him though, he's teammate able to cut out that attack. As that hopeful ball trickles out of play for a Japanese goal kick. Another change by Japan. And it'll be their final one of the night. Your pardon, they are allowed unlimited substitutions, which means that they can get all of their players on the pitch. Only one is yet to make an appearance. Kondo Kraba substituted out to be replaced by Yamato Ren. The free kick has been awarded Japan's way after, beg your pardon, no, throw-in has been given. Last touch judged to be off. The Nepalese defender, great turn, and surely he was bundled over, but the referee says that he had already lost control of the ball. I think the correct decision on that occasion. Nepal get it clear. But it's going to come back at them. Takumi, the right back. He has his pass cut out. Japan once again in possession. Gone wide. Cutback is intercepted. The Nepal trying to play their way out of trouble. The goalkeeper done no favors by his defender. He's had to concede a corner kick. Different corner kick routine. This one is lobbed through to the second post. Header by Honda Riku. Well held by Roshan Thapa, who's had a good game. And it's not often you can say the goalkeeper has had a good game after conceding 8. Japan building slowly. Long ball tried to play the left back in behind the Nepal defense, unfortunately drifting out of play. Last 10 minutes of the game. Japan have slowed down a bit since the substitution of their captain. And that's a poor pass by the midfielder for Nepal. And it's been bundled over Naoki. Free kick for Japan. The regular substitutions in the second half have made it difficult for the team to gel. But they've still been class apart. That's a great delivery and only just missing out on an own goal. Absolutely fantastic ball in there. Exactly what you want from a free kick in that position. Curling in between the defense line and the goalkeeper. And luckily for the Nepal defender, ball just evading the front post and going out of play. Japan continue their run forward and searing run and a good drive at goal from the number 14 Hikaru off target, and Nepal now within touching distance of the end. What has been a very difficult night for them. They'll take on Sri Lanka next. There's a cheeky attempt at goal there. Goes wide of the far post. But as I was saying, Nepal, they have a game against Sri Lanka where it'll be a slightly more equal footing. And that'll be on the 14th of March at 7 p.m. And prior to that, Japan will take on Bhutan at 5 p.m. on 14th. You can catch both of those games live on thepaparay.com as well as we continue our coverage of the South Asia Japan Under 16 Football Exchange Program. Japan holding on to the ball well, as they have done for most of the game. Eventual long ball forward, though. Too long for the forward, as it just runs out of play. It's been a tough night for the Nepalese youngsters. The Japan team, well drilled outfit, the many skillful players, as here they have another chance for themselves. Unselfish and a deserved goal for Japan. Very unselfish play by Sutotna Oke, who cut into the box. He had the opportunity to take the shot on himself. Instead, he decided to square the ball, and Nakano Keita did not disappoint with the finish, as it becomes 9-0 in favor of Japan with just under 5 minutes of regulation time to be played. Japan on their way forward again. Is that goal scorer chips it in, and last ditch defending sees Nepal get the ball clear. They have a free kick now, just inside the opposition half. Which they are in no hurry to take. A long ball going goalwards, and had the goalkeeper worried for a bit. Made it look easy, but he had to backpedal and take that effort at goal. Certainly caught him unawares, but a good recovery by the keeper to make that save as Japan now move the ball around in an area where they've been for most of the game in the Nepalese half. Spread wide. Good delivery in, but no one could quite get on the end of it. They have a corner kick. Again, that tactic of not having many players in the box at the point of delivery continues. This one is a good delivery. The goalkeeper came and missed, but the defender unable to get the telling touch that was needed to turn the ball goalwards. That'll go down as an effort off target. Roshan Thapa with the goal kick. As Japan now come again. They certainly aren't done, and that was a fine effort from nearly 40 yards out. That drive only just going over the bar as Nepal make a substitutions themselves. Pukar Kadka coming on for Rana Magar. Beg your pardon, Ranjan Poon. Just 1 minute of regulation time remaining as Nepal look to run down the clock. What has been a difficult game for them. They've not had much luck, and the Japanese team have really been a class apart. Great control to bring that one down. Pass though is long. And Thapa collects with grateful hands. Lovely run from defense, and shot was delayed, and Nepal just about managed to get enough bodies behind as they have a player down with cramps as well. And that break in play will allow them to make some of these substitutions. First one is number 9 to come off. And number 17, Saugat Kavas, to be replaced by number 8, Kadka. Neither of them are the players that are down on the pitch at the moment. But they slowly make their way up to their feet. Play to continue. Drive from long range, wide of the target. And we've had just over 2 minutes of time added on to the end of the 90. And that's the end of the game. It's been a complete domination by Japan over their opponents from Nepal. 9-0 it finished in favor of the Japanese as a hat-trick from Kondo Kraba and a brace from the skipper Nishikawa Jun alongside 5 goal scorers contributing to a totally dominant performance over Nepal as they pick up their second win of the tournament. And do join us again live from the Racecourse Stadium on Tuesday 14th of March, where Japan will take on Bhutan at 5 p.m. and then Sri Lanka will bring the tournament to a close when they take on Nepal at 7 p.m. You can catch both of the games live on thepapare.com. That's on the 14th of March. This is Ashwin Dias signing off for thepapare.com from the Racecourse Stadium, sharing the passion.
Fitness Diaries, in a mission to uplift the fitness arena in Sri Lanka.